Was it a medical mistake or something else that led to a Louisville man's death?
That question has haunted a mother for more than 2 years until now.
Tonight, Dwayne Pullman brings the case into focus as he continues our in-depth investigation down the wrong tube. Dwayne?
Rick, Vicki, the mother contacted me after watching my original reports in May. At the center of this case is a key question. Was a small plastic tube, just like this one, inserted correctly by Louisville Metro EMS paramedics? Well, thanks to a high-tech piece of equipment called the dashboard, we could finally get some answers for that mother.
I guess I always had a soft spot for him. And
Jennifer Marks still grieves for her son.
I loved him.
2.5 years ago, Rob Marks, who suffered from severe asthma, was at a restaurant in Fern Creek when he began gasping for air.
So he was in trouble.
Right. Yes, he was.
A call went out to 911. Louisville EMS crews responded.
Ready?
Yep. Placing a breathing tube like this down Rob's throat to thrust in oxygen. But when Rob arrived at the hospital, the family says a doctor told them it was too late.
He told us that basically there wasn't any hope, that the Rob was probably brain dead.
And Mrs. Marks says the doctor told the family something else, something that still haunts them.
That the tube had been inserted into the stomach instead of into the airway.
It's a mistake that we revealed in our WLKY investigation in May, that across the country happens on average 1 out of 4 times.
1 in 4 times, not only is it misplaced, but the person who placed it is unaware that it's in the wrong place until the patient actually shows up in the emergency department.
As we discovered, Louisville Metro EMS has this. Continuous waveform capnography. Paramedics simply call it the dashboard, a state-of-the-art computer program that provides paramedics with instant feedback, telling them whether they've inserted the tube in the right place.
Because it'll let you know immediately. There's no question.
The Marks family watched our original investigation and called me.
I thought Rob's was an isolated case. I had no idea that that it could happen to many other people, too.
But did that mistake happen to Rob? We discovered the dashboard that saves lives also does something else. It records the results. When Rob was being treated, the dashboard captured it all. But Mrs. Marks says she never got any record of that or anything else.
We couldn't get any information.
So we requested the medical records, and with the consent of the Marks family, we got these. The actual readouts from EMS on the night crews tried to save Rob's life. Those records reveal paramedics struggling to restart Rob's heart, repeatedly shocking him to get a rhythm. But we zeroed in on this graph. It's the actual recording from the dashboard showing carbon dioxide was being captured, and that only happens when the patient is exhaling, which means Rob's tube was in the right place. And we found something else. This signature from an ER doctor stating the tube placement was correct. EMS did it right. Their efforts were just not enough to save Rob's life. The Marks family, which had long struggled with the question of what went wrong, finally got their answer.
It's very hard, and we struggled for a long time.
The dashboard, designed to save patients, had, in this case, protected the paramedics from being accused of making a mistake.
We can upload this data to our monitor and or upload it to our EPCR, so it becomes a part of the patient's care report, and it's there forever.
So if the dashboard saves lives and protects paramedics, why isn't the state requiring all paramedics to use it? I take that question to Frankfort and go one-on-one with the executive director of Kentucky's Board of EMS. Our investigation continues tonight on WLKY News. I'm Dwayne Pullman. I'll see you back here at 11.